crucial for us. I have to inform you that we're being filmed, and this film is live streamed online right now, and it's going to be projected on this screen tomorrow and archived. If you have a problem with being filmed, I guess it's much probably that you will be in this film, so you have to know it. I will ask you also to stay for the whole hour of the concert.
So the first thing we're going to do today is to separate Democrats from non-democratic people. So people who don't believe in democracy should come over here at this wall, and people who believe in democracy should go to the other one.
Can be democratic for 1 hour, and he said yes.
Right. But then, right. but is it then everybody's only majority rules? There's no possibility for like a...
I agree, so you can suggest something else.
Don't put it on me. I didn't ask the question.
So, okay, I rephrase it.
Can you sit in separate groups and each group can do what they want to do?
How will we decide about it?
Everybody has to rise his hands when he agrees with the idea, otherwise just keeps it on his waist.
Do you agree? I don't know.
I didn't understand.
So, right, like, I just suggest that, like, each group, or like, they're separate groups, and they can do whatever they want to do for an hour, so we don't have to match all the time with the same idea. And if you agree with this idea, you just have to raise your hand, otherwise you're not gonna like commit this idea, like go with this idea.
So there's parallel rules.
Exactly. So who's in with this idea?
Functions differently, and it's about coalitions, and I think it's not so simple as that. I mean, of course, I think we have to make a different definition of it, and if you say, okay, this is about majority rules, great, we can do this as a game for an hour, but then we should not call it democracy.
Okay, so in a democratic way, please suggest us a way to...
You're asking me again, but you know, it's, we're going on to your question, so we're trying to answer your question with a certain suggestion. Then you cannot bring it back to make up a new concept for politics that has been people looked for like hundreds of years.
Yeah, but we only want to do it for an hour, so maybe we can find a way. Why are you so negative about it?
We make suggestions, no? I mean, we tried.
What?
We made suggestions. He made a suggestion about making a separate groups that the whole group can act in a certain situation. It's not about making it one way or the other. There's certain things, certain practices that we try at the same time, which also functions in a little democracy. Certain rules could apply with separate groups that are parallel together. It's not about that everybody has to do the same thing, that it's only like normativity, actually.
And we are actually demonstrating the dissonance that you are suggesting in the instructions in this printout. Yes. That she, in the instructions, she actually, well, there is a social dissonance, and we are asked to deal with that with our bodies and movements, and that's actually what's happening right now, as we have divided ourselves from the majority group, and it's resulting in a dissonance.
Do you agree that we comply to this one simple rule that we speak one by one? So we can be heard?
Yes.
Okay.
So how are you helping smaller groups?
Sorry?
If we have to speak one by one, how will we help smaller groups? Speaking at the same time.
But that's the information that it's about speaking.
No. We didn't know that we had to just speak. We could also just move, right?
Yeah. We could play, we could make sounds, we could make music.
But how
well, I mean, in the end, we need a topic first, right, to like find groups, and we need like groups with probably like same opinions or whatever.
This is the topic.
What is the same organization that represents around? So maybe we can pick a topic, as you suggested.
Thinks capitalism is good?
Yeah.
Let's make two sides of the room. Who believes that capitalism is good, they go from this side, and who believes it's bad from the other?
Capitalism and the other people
don't.
Things who don't.
The question is quite tricky to separate
like all questions are quite hard to answer if it's like a white yes or no.
Of three groups. One group, yes, problem, yes, no, I don't know.
This research is about sociability in a space, in a new space with unknown people, so we're trying to deal with this space, which is problematic because of the sound and because we are all different from different backgrounds and we speak different languages. So if you have better suggestions, please imply them.
But okay, like, do you want us in general to discuss about those things, or is it just about that we do something for an hour and, like, how do you say that, like, form some kind of a society in this hour?
The idea is that we interpret this core altogether.
Okay, I see.
But the way is not fixed.
Yeah.
Sorry. Okay, so in the introduction, I said that we're going to ask for feedback if you want to leave in the middle of the hour. So I just reminded because I saw some people leaving without giving feedback. What?
We're here.
Yeah, if you want to leave, I just remind you that we have to.
Also, you can vote if you want us to be the performers, or you want some of you to be the performers.
Are there performers?
Sorry?
Are there performers?
What would you like to perform?
No, I mean, do you want to be at my position and keep the phone and regulate this? You can be. You can vote and you can decide if you want us to regulate this or not.
You see?
I think you should be with the boss.
I don't.
You think it's
deciding more things.
Can you explain why?
That's what I experience, that the situation is kind of awkward, and I think this is dissonance.
To do something, play a game or work, do whatever. And some people are sitting next to me right now. And yeah, it's cool. It's just some kind of an experiment where you can hang on for a while, check other people's their direction.
That you can vote if you want us to be at this place, at this position, or you don't?
What is this position? Performing.
What is your position about?
What is your position about?
Is it just holding the phone? Or
being a cameraman? Or are you organizing? Are you leading the hour? What is your activity?
To take the responsibility to deal with this space. Would you like to take it?
No, but it's good to know that you have it.
Document. I don't have it.
Can she maybe open the door? Then it would be much easier for me to stay here. I would like to be here for 1 hour, but when the door is closed, I think I can't.
Like claustrophobia?
No, it's not very well.
I thought you also meant it from the social perspective.
So now we are voting who wants the door.
Thank you.
Do you want me to take a group photo?
Okay, do you want us to read the score and try to start from this point?
No.
Who wants it? Who wants us to read the score?
Do what?
Who wants us to read the score out loud and start interpreting it from reading it?
But I think you're already doing that. We are, suddenly this has become this political space that we're trying to figuring out, talking about, describing our own, reflecting our own actions from the beginning. I think it's already happening. I think we could just continue it, seeing where it takes us.
Does anyone, like everybody of you guys, know why he or she entered the room?
Huh? What?
Does anybody of you know why he or she entered the room?
Yeah.
Accidentally.
I actually thought it was going to be like a performance and we're just like the audience sitting here and watching people doing something.
Would that be better for you?
No, I mean not. I guess it's probably more interesting than just watching somebody do
something. I mean, I feel like all of us are doing that in all of your performers. So like you have an option to watch what's happening, but you're like being an outlet performer.
Yeah. Behind the stage.
Yeah.
As a
actually, the performer is more often the person that is standing up than the performer is somebody who is sitting. So, why do you claim us to be performers?
Because, well, in a Brechtian theater, you would be also the audience would be the performer, part of the theater stage. I thought it was an interesting challenge to have us be the people performing or just being the audience at the same time, because we would have to paint through it, and I knew it would be something where we would have to paint through it.
Perhaps we can start and everybody say something about him, where you come from and what are you doing here perhaps, or something that in my opinion it's nice to feel more together. My English is very bad.
If everybody introduces himself, we can start to find some kind of society. I mean, this is interesting and very exciting experience. First, the question Democrats, and then everybody feels very sure we are Democrats. How to deal with it is a complicated thing. It's work, and this is what we now feel. I mean, we sense it. And if we would like to come a little bit closer together.
Yes.
Introduction.
Do an introduction for yourself.
Yes, I already said I entered this room because just outside, people were waiting. There's a performance. I was just... Interested and what performance? Okay, I expected something more. Yes, and this is now.
What did you want to say? You
said you asked if we should get comfortable.
Yeah, I like your idea. I agree that we should all get comfortable with one another, because right now, I think I have trouble. The fact that you're like four white men taking over this space with like, when you're extroverted, applaud. But like that already like puts me in an uncomfortable place where I don't want to listen to four men, you know, like white men. We all have to do that already throughout our day in like the systemic oppression. So it would be nice in like a democracy, in like this democratic area, if we could all just like be equal for 1 second, you know, like all have a voice, whereas like you're taking control and like you feel this manpower to like grab the scene, But it would be nice if we all had a voice. Like, I don't know anything about that side of the room, but I feel like I've heard a little bit about these voices.
I completely agree with you. This is a somewhat strange form man. Who are the four men? I just missed that mark. Sorry, I just thought she's one of the artists, I think, and she, I don't know where you're from.
I am a girl.
She's like, awesome.
Well, that's right. I didn't notice before.
We had two suggestions about introducing himself and about all sitting down in a circle and perhaps we should vote in a democratic way about these two suggestions.
Yeah,
maybe
I say something.
No, I'd really like to talk about the point that you just said because I would have never imagined that you would feel like this just because people are like, I don't know, talking and I don't know, starting to make actions. Because I would have never like related it to any gender or, yeah.
I think we should listen to the three women's suggestions before we talk about feelings. So, I second the vote. Do we want to get in the circle? Do we want to make introductions?
But if we vote, we're going to do what the majority says because we didn't agree.
Comfortable, but it's very hard for me to say like or to introduce myself because normally I would say what I'm doing and that I was studying architecture. But right now I'm starting to think about if that's really what defines me as the person that I am. But yeah, in general, like to give you some information about who I am. Like I was studying architecture with those guys here, and we're here over the weekend to visit this.
Yes.
Can we leave the room?
Could we analyze the people that they have already spoke and try to understand why they have all this confidence?
Sorry?
Could we analyze him, for example, and try to understand where he draws this confidence from, like...
Men in general do have a voice compared to women, and they feel more confident about speaking in public, about, I don't know, talking about important issues.
So are you confident because you're a man?
No, I would say so, but there's lots of men who are... I don't want to... No, but like in the end, I think it's not so much about like being a man or being a woman, maybe it's harder for women than for men to speak in public. I don't know. I can't say because I haven't felt both ways. But I think there's lots of men as well who feel uncomfortable about themselves.
Of course. Yeah, you have friends. Are you here alone?
No, I'm here with those two guys and then taking photos.
So I think that also makes you more just comfortable. Like you're in a space with someone. Whereas,
so why would he be the first one? I mean, he wasn't the first one to walk around. He really, you already have walking around. He really mimicked what you were already doing. So why would you mention him as the one that would have the confidence to walk around?
I don't know. I'm always curious about how people find the confidence to take, to be the center of attention.
To what?
To be the center of attention.
Well, I think you're in the center of attention. You're in the middle.
I'm the center of a camera.
I think that we started with the matter of politics, and maybe it's what's the word, overgeneralization, but don't we usually see more men in politics than we see women? So that's just a smaller part of that happening here. So it's normal for men to talk.
And it's white. Something like white men.
It's not that they don't have the right to talk, I just, you see, I stutter now. And I'm a presenter, that's my job. And I don't normally stutter. But now I'm a bit afraid to talk here.
Okay.
About that.
Why do you feel afraid?
I don't know.
The question is why you're not. That was the original question.
I can't say that. I can't define why I'm not afraid. I would just, like, I felt natural in the first place that it's like, or that it would be cool if everybody was like, just talking freely. And I think that was for me the first intention of saying something that I wanted to kind of break the ice and make it normal for everybody to say something. I was just trying to explain why I wasn't afraid. I mean, I guess like in the beginning I felt more awkward about talking here than I do right now. But I wouldn't say that it's a fact because I'm a man.
I'll say that the only reason why I started talking is because I noticed that it was dominantly men who were talking. And I'm in school right now, in class situations mostly. It's mostly men who start to speak, and I've had to take this function as someone who counterbalances them. So I've been comfortable, I've been accustomed to that.
I didn't ask you to ask me to that, but are you comfortable with it or not?
Oh, no.
Okay. For me too,
yeah.
I don't like it. Always, it's always the same. I don't like it.
I just think it's interesting that you don't realize that.
But you still don't realize that?
What?
After having four women telling you that they have different...
But not just him. I don't want to pick on him.
I want to.
Like, it's like...
I mean, you're talking about this, so you don't feel...
Well, no, and that's fine. That's fine. Like, now we all have a voice in this. But, like... Even when introducing, she brought up the idea to introduce, and you immediately were like, I'm an architect,
No,
I don't. But no, and I think that and I don't think you're doing something genuine where you want to break the ice, and that's, I think that's awesome.
I actually just did that because it was asked to,
and I think that's good, but then like let's hyper-analyze all those actions and why you're doing them. Yeah. Like I think we all have to recognize.
I'm feeling very comfortable seeing women who feel the same thing as me. I think that is good that we talk about it.
Can I propose something?
Yeah.
And I suggest that we vote for it if we want to do that. Maybe for this hour we could introduce a way of speaking that is more even for women and like do something like, I don't know, it's just a suggestion that for one man speaking there has to be one woman speaking afterwards, or if there is not, we just wait until a woman wants to speak. What?
At the end, yes, and because for myself, I didn't realize it the same as you guys did. And for me, it's not the same feeling, to be serious. I give no attention about like if a man is starting a conversation about women, or women in general. Yeah, sure. Like, I don't see a difference in between, like, conversations, and I don't really realize if, like, a man is starting a conversation or a woman is starting it. So, for me, it's completely equal, and it depends on the situation where I am and whatever. But in university, for example, I'm totally used to both, like, women or men talking the same quality or in the same, like, how to say, relation actually, like in this, with the same level actually. But it definitely depends on, for example, in university on the topic of studies, or like the studies you're doing, for example, as well as like which topic you're talking about, for example, how comfortable like you're feeling with it, and so on and so on. So, not feeling the same, and it's like it's totally cool that you feel in a way and you talk about it and feel more curious and, or I'm not sure if you can say curious, but like to say it actually safer in a way, and with more people in the same boat, for example, like it's completely going in the wrong direction, because it's like I can't explain why I am feeling completely different to the conversation you guys had before, and like, but I'm totally cool that you feel in a way, but I more or less actually know why you feel the way, and it's interesting for me that you feel in a certain way. So it's like, which kind of situations do you feel the way you felt like in your own situation? Did somebody get the point I was going
on? I mean, I agree with you. Okay. I didn't see that situation that you describe, that you describe about the man being more. I didn't really notice, or what race you are. I didn't realize it. I mean, I can relate when in certain situations, like I come from Bolivia, and there are certain parts of Bolivia that you notice these dynamics where, like in Santa Cruz, in the Orient of Bolivia, South America, you will notice like in an event like a barbecue, something just social like that, where men will gravitate and be among themselves, and the women will gravitate among themselves, and the conversation dynamics will be totally different. And I absolutely hate it, and that's really, really obvious. And here I haven't noticed it at all. I myself thought I was participating. And I also think that whoever is quiet, if they want to be quiet, that's okay, but it's their own responsibility. I didn't notice that. I think that the ones who talk shouldn't be accused for talking. Instead, you know, I think there's enough space for everybody to speak.
Yes, but the space is there, indeed. It is there. Everyone can talk. The question is, why won't some people talk?
I don't know.
Why
where somehow people are talking. Somebody has to start a certain conversation or has to find out some kind of topics to come to a certain conversation, to break the ice, as you said, and so on. So like coming to a fluent conversation to make it more comfortable for everybody in the end, actually. Or it's not the same. Like, as you told me, like, did you say everybody can speak, but only a few are taking the possibility to speak and to like speak louder, but they really want to think about what they want to say. So is it more that they are somewhat braver, or like?
It's not really like that. I'm sorry for interrupting you, but it's not really like that. What we said before, and what I believe, I'm sorry, is that it's easier for a white man to talk, to start talking in a situation like this, than for a woman or for a person of color or whatever.
It's not, for me, it's not difficult. And I don't know what race you think I am. I mean, I don't know myself, but I don't see it that way. I mean, we can continue arguing.
Can I ask
forever,
you something?
I'm sorry.
Do you have a PhD?
No.
Do you do studies or?
I'm a teacher. I'm an art teacher.
Okay.
So maybe that's why teachers usually are used to speaking in public. He's a teacher too.
I don't find he's a quiet.
He's a quiet. For example,
it could be.
In the start, he felt comfortable enough to be alone and stand alone, so he's confident in public situations. So maybe you are an exception because you're a teacher and you're pretty used to speaking in public. And yeah, but generally, I think it is more difficult for women to speak in public. And I don't think you are the one to say that it's equal, because you are a man. And so, if it is equal or not, maybe it should be us to say it.
Okay. But maybe we should ask those who haven't spoken, why haven't they spoken, instead of making assumptions. I mean, to say that women have more difficulty speaking, there you would still have to make a more closer analysis to be able to come up with that conclusion. Although, in Bolivia, I would agree that that's the truth.
You haven't spoken, for example.
Yeah. So this was my first word. I can't say why I haven't spoken. I don't know.
Can I have a look? What are you writing down?
Sorry?
What are you writing down?
I'm writing down what is happening.
Can you tell us what has happened?
Well, on my notes, it has happened that that we were asked if we believe in democracy, and then that the group was separating. I can't read my. Was it democratic? Who thinks believe in capitalism? Three groups? ? You can vote if we. You can vote if you want to be the performers. I'm just reading what I wrote. Do we have to discuss more? This is dissonance. How do we deal with it? I can't read again. She's performing dissonance. And that's it.
Using the same topic as you guys were talking before, because I'm really interested in why. Because now, taking it as a question, do other women think the same way?
I don't feel that way at all. Maybe that's because I'm white and I don't think about race.
Whoa.
I don't think about races at all, never. Maybe because that's not as much of a topic in Germany, maybe. And you might feel differently because
you might have been separated from other people because of your race. I don't know that. I've never felt that way, and that's why I never really think about women and men speaking, because what you just said, I totally agree that everybody had the space and the opportunity to talk if they wanted to, and there were some women who did as well. And so I think it's more about confidence than about being a man or being a woman.
Do you think that your ability to speak, just in general, is largely in part because this is a predominantly white space? And
can I interrupt you? I don't think so, because I'm German, so talking in English is also a thing that makes me uncomfortable a little bit. So maybe I think that all the people who think that English is really good, you were the ones who were talking more confidently because it's easier. And I think that's what's holding back some of us in a way.
I was also thinking that. Like, I think it's interesting that
we didn't talk about
language. Yeah, that we're choosing to speak English. Mm-hmm. Where I'm sure most of them do could speak German right now and continue the conversation in German.
Well, it's written in English.
It's also in German.
German.
Oh,
it's
also in German. Okay.
Yeah. But I think it's because you started speaking in English.
Yeah, we don't know any German.
Yeah, I don't speak German also.
But just another thing that we will not vote for, and we will not do it, that we all speak terrible English, so nobody has a problem. We can speak like that and...
As more natural as comes for you.
Very bad. And then, I don't know, maybe it would be more easy for the other.
Yeah, but just make me less confident talking about
it. But I would like to hear what you would like to say, because she interrupted you and I didn't hear
I'm the darkest person in here. For me, it's definitely a lot harder. I've been trying to build up the muster to speak for about 20 minutes now. So, I'm from New York. I grew up in Brooklyn. I've grown up with racism my whole life, and dealing with predominantly white spaces where my voice is oftentimes pushed to the back burner just because I'm the odd one out of the group. And so a lot of times I get to a point where it becomes a lot harder for me to even want to speak, especially when I don't see anyone that shares my complexion who might have a chance of sharing my experience. I find it Germany is a predominantly white society, you can admit to that. And when I brought up the question of do you think that as a whole it's potentially easier for you to speak, I'm thinking of it in the sense that when you have a society where the most of the people that you see in the public lens share the same complexion as you, it gives you more confidence because you're essentially on your own home turf. And wherever I go, for the most part, wherever I go within industrialized Western society, I'm going to be the minority in a sense. So it definitely proves to be difficult a lot of times to get my to feel like my voice is ever going to be regarded for anything valuable. Do you all?
What we could do to make it easier for everybody to like talk, because I would have, like, seriously, I would have never thought that that ideas that came up now would come up, because I would have never felt that way. I mean, that's exactly what you said. I guess it's because I'm not in the same situation as some of you guys are, but. Still, I think it would be like really interesting to think about ideas and concepts, how to make it easier for everybody in this group or everybody in our society to just have a voice and to say what they want to say.
Just ask and listen. So I
just sit back and listen a bit. But yeah, I want to say something what you said, that you didn't experience any racism because you're a white girl in Germany. But if you don't experience this, it doesn't mean it doesn't exist. So sometimes if you just open your eyes, you see it everywhere. Even in Germany, even in, I come from Cologne, in a neighborhood where a lot of different cultures live, you just hear this one sentence or this one word, or at work when you have lunch, somebody says something and then you're like, this is, you didn't really say that. So just listen. And I think it's the same with different culture, different gender. If you ask the people and listen, then at one point in time they will come around and tell you the story.
Right at the beginning, where everybody was standing here and nobody was talking, like imagine somebody came up and just started saying like, hey, say something about yourself. I mean, there's like, right, some kind of relation building up, that somebody is putting himself in a different position than the other person, and also there is somebody who's like the first person to say something. And I think it's like, for me it would be more interesting like how we can how do you say that, like give everybody the feeling to be comfortable to just like start and say something and have a voice.
I think it's about the style of questioning. If you say something about yourself and you put them in the spotlight, if you say, hey, where do you come from, I don't know, I like your shoes, whatever, then it's different. Then you start the conversation and it's not more like, now you have to say and now you have to introduce yourself, because I feel comfortable with introducing myself, but I know that a lot of people don't, so when you talk to those people, you just make it a little bit more easy for them if you just have a conversation. Just my opinion.
Can I ask you something? Was ich für mich total interessant fand, weil ich zwar teilweise etwas verstanden habe, aber ich habe nicht alles verstanden, weil die Akustik extrem schlecht ist und weil mein Englisch nicht so gut ist. Und ich habe mir die ganze Zeit überlegt, wie schwierig das ist, ja, Argumenten zu folgen oder überhaupt dem Gespräch zu folgen, wenn man dieser Sprache nicht mächtig ist. Und habe gedacht, das ist, auch ich kann mich auf Englisch nicht so gut ausdrücken, wie ich mich das natürlich in meiner Muttersprache kann. Und dass man sich so richtig abgestellt vorkommt und irgendwie ein bisschen dumm. Und ich habe gedacht, dass es ganz vielen Menschen so geht, die einfach in anderen Ländern leben und dort irgendwie ankommen müssen. Und wenn du dann eben A, nicht alles verstehst und B, deine Gedanken und Gefühle nicht so ausdrücken kannst, wie sie wirklich authentisch sind, dass es eine ganz schwierige Situation ist. Und ich fand, ich habe es jetzt auf Englisch gesagt, auf Deutsch gesagt, es tut mir leid, dass viele es nicht verstehen. Ja, aber das war für mich gerade eine gute Erkenntnis, weil ich es richtig gespürt habe, wie doof man sich eigentlich fühlt. Kann jemand gut Englisch und könnte das übersetzen? Gerne auch einer von den Herren.
Yes, no, I think okay. He said it's very difficult if you are in a situation where you don't speak the language good, and it's difficult to hear it because of the acoustic. And that you learn are in a position where you feel stupid because you are the one that don't understand the opinions of the others.
Okay, and we felt stupid now too, so
yes.
Okay.
And she found it interesting to be in the position now because she isn't normally.
Yeah.
Yes. I understand, but there are some things that we could have done in order for this situation to be more horizontal, but we chose not to do anything for that. We could try, I don't know, not speaking and doing something physical, which everybody could participate. We could have tried, because it was an issue that was up in the table today about the gender. We could have tried some things that could encourage women to speak more. And it's obvious that there is this inequality between men and women. This is not something new. Maybe some women are confident because they are as people, but on the whole, there is this rule that it's a rule. So we could have tried to do something for that instead of leaving white males use their privilege in order to be dominant in this situation. We could have tried, I don't know, even talking in German and using translation. We could have done so many things. It was so much open space, but we somehow decided not to take any decisions in order to change the situation in any way that would be more democratic or more horizontal, or I don't know.
I feel like we got there, though, didn't we? Like,
yeah.
She went into her language that was more comfortable. We had a translator.
To come back to this question, what would be a good proposal about being more horizontal or whatever? So. Is there a good proposal what we could do about it? Because that was
how are we going to do this? I mean, if somebody suggests something and nobody pays attention and they just go on speaking because they can, how will we do this? How will we set rules to organize our connection in another way?
Are you saying that this dynamic is not going like how you plan?
We're not coming up with any solutions. Like, we're talking about it, but we're...
But I think maybe this was the space to just talk about it and to bring out
certain
tensions.
I think there was very good distribution of voices today, for example.
Because of the context of what we were saying that encouraged people to speak about this, because this was the context itself.
Mm.
But if it wasn't,